Hare Krishna. To forget that the world is a hurtful place is to place ourselves on a path full of hurts. Suppose we are in a place which is, say, filled with thorns. And if we forget that and we start walking, then we'll get pierced. Now, if we are cautious, then we can, maybe we can wear some protective gear, some thick footwear, or we can try to see the path where there are the least thorns and then move on. So similarly, the world itself is a hurtful place. Hurtful place means that here people can hurt us, nature can hurt us, and we ourselves can hurt us. So we need to navigate our way carefully so that we can get out of this hurtful place, so that we can rise from material consciousness to spiritual consciousness. But suppose we are in a place filled with thorns and we go deeper within that thorn-filled place, then we hurt ourselves more and more. But if we carefully choose the path that will take us out of that thorn-filled place, then although there will be cut, but it will be minimal and eventually it will stop. So now, of course, thorns are visible and immediately painful. But the world's pains are neither as visible as thorns nor as immediately perceivable as thorns. In fact, we could say the world is more like a place which is like a normal land interspersed with terrible quicksands. So we don't know when danger will come. Sometimes we can perceive, maybe there is a quicksand over it, but sometimes the quicksand just comes when we take the next step, and thus we get sucked in. So the territory looks often good, especially in today's world with so much technological advancement. We have created lots of comforts which blind us to the reality of how harsh the world is. And if we don't recognize that we can't find pleasure in the world itself, we need to raise our consciousness. If we don't realize this, then we start pursuing material pleasures recklessly, and the pleasures will lead us to trouble. Yehi samsparshija bhoga dukkayonaya evate. That it's like a quicksand which looks nice, solid, but it is going to suck us completely and put us in misery. Recognizing this, when we strive to raise ourselves to spiritual consciousness, then we don't put ourselves in a place full of hurts, on a path full of hurts, but we slowly find a path that can get us out of all those hurts. This is what the Bhagavad Gita recommends in its 8th chapter, 15th verse. Mam upetya punarjanma dukkhale mashashvatam naapnuvanti mahatmanah samsiddhim paramam gataha. That paramam gataha. Dukkhalaya shashvata, this world is filled with distress, it is temporary. But if we become devoted to Krishna, then we can go beyond this world and ultimately attain Him. Thereby freeing ourselves from the hurtful place that the world is. Hare Krishna.